This show is brought to you by Slice on Broadway, supporting Pittsburgh podcasting with the perfect pepperoni pizza, sliceonbroadway.com. And listeners like you, support this show at patreon.com/awesomecast. Hey guys, it's the AwesomeCast 293. I'm Mike Sorg at Sorgatron on Twitter's here in Mayhem Studios in Pittsburgh, PA, ready to talk tech, get geeky, all kinds of fun stuff here on the AwesomeCast. And we got a great crew with us. First of all, from Studio C is John Chilla joining us. How you doing, Chilla?
Pretty good. How are you?
All right, man. Welcome back. We missed you last week, but Chachi and I got to hang out. So it was pretty good. Not too much video games, unfortunately. So, good. How was your week off?
It was good. The little 2-year-old turned 2.
Oh, nice. Ooh. Nice.
So we had a lot of birthday festivities and fun.
Awesome. And of course, as I'm on the fly fixing somebody's title, we have in studio, wow, look, there's people on the couch. First of all, Frank Murgia of Pittsburgh Podcast Network is with us. You may remember him from the Awesome Chat, but his first time on the Awesome Cast. Welcome.
Welcome. I survived. I made it to the next level.
Yes, you did.
I'm going to fix the next level of shows. Thank you for having me.
I'm going to fix your mic here, figure out where you're at.
Who are you?
Yes. Or maybe I might have this backwards, to be honest. And also with us, Katie Dudas is back in the studio. Dudders, K Dudders on the Twitter, of course, working with Sidekick Media Services and the Scare House, mm-hmm. doing the social media things. That's all I got.
Yeah. Awesome.
But this is the Awesome Cast. Like I said, you can check out everything at awesomecast.net. You can subscribe to this show and check out the past interviews. We are scheduling some new ones to hopefully fill that up. We don't get them every week, but we get them when we can because we want to make sure there's quality for one thing. And we have a lot of fun with those. You can tune into us every Tuesday night. We're fiddling around with technology and trying to get it work about 6:30 p.m. Eastern time. So you can check out that amazingness over at live.sorgatronmedia.com. And join us in the chat room, just like our good friends. Missy's in there doing the notes and the tweets. Tragar's with us, of course. Wheels is in there, our MVP. Crazy Krause is in there as well. And Chilla's hanging out with everybody, too. So, and also, you can check us out every Thursday at 8 a.m. over on riversedgepgh.com. That's right after Funny Money over there. So go please check that out. And big thanks to our Patreon supporters, patreon.com/awesomecast. If you're interested to support the show, thank you to those who have. I know the Patreon payments have gone through. We've supported our shows, and the people that have supported us have gone through as well. Thistlesea Business Development, our friends up at Cranberry Township at Thistlesea on the Twitter. And of course, the Michael Fedor Show at Mike Fedor Show on Twitter at Mike Fedor Show. Thank you so much to them, longtime supporters of the show on the executive producer level, and really cool to see them really getting in the show enough to put their money where their mouth is and getting into the show that way. Thank you so much for that. So let's get into it with our awesome things of the week. We got a lot of things going on here, so let's get started. Well, hey, Chilla, what do you got? And this is something I was definitely excited about when I heard about it and realized what the heck it was, because I don't think I've heard of this before.
So and I actually hadn't heard about it either, and I think it was like in the hundreds of dollars to buy this. But Google released the Nik Collection for free. So if you're a fiddler of photos, it's definitely worth the download. If you're a professional photographer, you probably unfortunately already paid for this. But I think through Google's acquisitions of Snapseed and some of the other tools, they bought a lot of filtering technology, and they've recently released that technology for free. So I know Silver Effects, which is spelled EFEX, was a big one for people going and turning stuff black and white. They've released all of these plugins for free in there. It's an easy download right from their website. They install, it's pretty neat. They work with Photoshop CS4 and above, some of the stuff requires CS5 or above, but and they go all the way through current day. It even works with the Elements platform, Lightroom, and even goes back to Apple Aperture on the Mac. And then so the pretty much the same on the Windows side. But with these filter sets, I mean, you get a lot of great filter tools. Like there's a professional sharpening tool, there's an HDR effects filter, which when you look at these types of filters, just to help illustrate the picture or illustrate the money that you're saving by downloading these free from Google, I think a professional sharpening tool usually runs in the $70 to $100 price range. HDR tool sets I've seen ranging anywhere from $50 to $200, and these are all free. I highly recommend going out to google.com/NIK collection and taking a look at these filters. I downloaded them and I'm going to definitely start playing around with them more, just for my own kind of pro-am fiddling around with photos. And I'm on, what's it called? DeviantArt. So I post a lot of photos out there. So these are a great set of tools to use out there.
That's awesome. And I haven't gone, I mean, I'm not deep into Photoshop. Go enough to do a little bit of graphic and flyering kind of stuff, but no, it sounds like, yeah, this was it weighs in, it's even a hefty plugin set that weighs in about 300 megabytes too, so it took a little bit to bring down. I think it's really cool to have that kind of ability. I can't wait to get the chance to shared this out to everybody I know that's a photography nut. I was like, here, you should probably download this. Here, you should probably download this. And that's really cool. Now this is a company, they bought a company that these belong to, right? And they had just been selling them through Google in the meantime, and obviously they acquired whatever other assets, and I think they applied it to like Picasa or Google Images or Google Photos, I guess. Mm-hmm. Is that sound like the story you've been hearing too?
That's the story I've been hearing too. And I think they got, like I said, I think they got these through acquisitions, mm-hmm. Like Snapseed, and I think they bought a couple other companies that had these filters embedded, and they were selling them to continue to make money while they embedded them in their other products.
That's awesome. So go check it out. I mean, you can just Google the Google Nik NIK collection, or you can go to google.com/Nik collection, and you can download those. And you have to specifically download Mac or PC versions of it as well. So be aware of that too. I'm thinking of that as I have to put it on different platforms that we have Photoshop on around here. So definitely. Katie, I know you're a photo buff. Have you been looking at these?
Yeah, they're actually, I like, I just had it pulled up for a second ago.
Come on, Katie.
Sorry, I know. Sorry, I pulled it. I switched to Windows. I shoot a lot in RAW, so it was nice seeing there was something for a sharpener there. And but I haven't played with it as much as I'd like, but the color effects one is awesome too.
Awesome. Awesome. Cool. So there you go. Thanks, Chilla. Go check that out. Katie, what is your awesome thing of the week while we're at it?
Butt touching.
Okay. Well, there you go.
Yes.
I knew you would bring it. Yeah, I knew you would go there.
I know. I was like, Frank's here. I have to step up my game. So there was research done. There is a robot that is teaching. Yeah, research.
Oh, no. This was accurate.
What did you think? I wasn't really going to bring
it. I don't know. You just kind of say that. Like, and like business meetings with us half the time. So,
yeah, but touching.
No, but there it is.
Yeah, there's a robot, and he is actually, it was a study done. And they were talking, what this robot was supposed to do was the robot would ask participants to touch a part of his body, his or her body. I'm not sure. Sorry. And after they would touch it, the robot would reply with a medical term for the body part. So the robot tells you, touch my hand. If you go down a little bit, you can play the video.
Oh, okay. Video. Is there a video?
There's
okay,
a let's video. Let's see what this is about. Okay, yeah, because you'll watch it for a while, and the gentleman touches the robot's hand. The robot says something. And then the robot tells the gentleman to touch his butt, and it makes them kind of, you can see the hesitation. So they, based upon this research, they found that humans were, even though it's a robot, they don't like to touch these what they call low accessibility areas, mm-hmm. which is the butt and, in the article, junk. So there was a delay in wanting to touch those parts of the body.
Junk.
Yep, junk.
And it's a fun robot. So is it just sitting there most of the time?
Yeah, the robot's not even doing anything. And, yeah. Nothing really changes. It just says, hey, touch my hand. hey, touch my butt. And humans are like, yeah, finger.
Well, to be fair, the robot did give permission first. So
Yes. It, the robot asked for it. So it was okay.
it had consent.
Yes.
There you go.
So yeah, so humans are not comfortable touching robot low accessibility areas.
They repeated the process in 13 body parts. Mm-hmm. Yeah, touch his head. Okay.
Touch my ear.
Response, right? Mm-hmm. Touch my ear. And do we actually see? Here we go.
Here we go. The buttocks.
Low accessibility, like the buttocks.
Touch my butt.
Nope. There you go.
But there was a little pause for a lot of people. So they discovered that we do not like to touch robot body parts. Well, butt parts.
Are you sure, Mr. Robot? Is that really what you want from me, Mr. Robot? All right. Frank Murgia of Pittsburgh Podcast Network joining us. What is your awesome thing of the week?
Well, we're going to keep it filthy. Like Katie decided to go to right into the gutter with a robot. I got you can now order condoms with a push of a button.
Mm-hmm.
This is the Amazon Dash buttons.
Mm-hmm.
The product line they have, these little items. They have over like 100 products. And with the condom, they have a Trojan Dash button. You can click on that and you can order Trojans. If you're in need of a condom, but here's the thing. You can't get it right away. Amazon Prime, there's still two-day delivery.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean... You're still planning ahead. So I thought it was kind of odd. I think it's more gimmicky, but I thought it was kind of funny and awesome. They have that for Trojan. You just click the button, and in 2 days, you'll have free delivery of Trojan condoms. So plan ahead, guys. You know, but they also have – I find these Dash buttons interesting with Amazon. There's over 100 of them now. They rolled out a whole line. You know, there's Tide, Bounty, Cottonelle. They have Gatorade, Pepsi. There's over 100 of these things. It seems fun. It's kitschy. It's a nice little thing. But how lazy have we become? it's the cranky Frankie. It's like crossum. I call it crossum. I'm cranky and cross and awesome. I don't know. Is anybody using these things? If you're in the basement, you're out of Tide. You know, you have your little Dash button on top of your washing machine. I see the commercial for that. Can't we just hit our phone and just order this right up on our phone? An extra 30 seconds. So I think it's kind of cool if you have a couple of these you like. Mm-hmm. Now with but you can't have just one, right? Yeah, you need more than one. There's always more than one or two products that you like. So maybe I want a Pepsi, a Gatorade, the Trojans, some Kleenex.
You just line them up, you know. You just line them up.
Them up, I mean,
by
the
fridge.
Your pocket.
Right, exactly.
But I mean, you can't really have a Trojan button without a little blue pill, like button.
It is blue. The button should be blue.
Yeah.
I thought it was kind of awesome and cool, but I'm also a little cranky on these items that. Do we really need all of these items? Like, there's just a little thing on the keychain. Remember they had the, all your Walgreens, your Rite Aid, your Perks, everything's on your keychain, these little plastic things. But now where are we going to hang all? Like a janitor has all those keys. We're going to have like 14 of these Dash buttons. So, I think it's kind of awesome they have Trojan because it's a great talking point. But do we really need these?
Right, exactly.
I feel like Chilla's house is just covered in these.
No, it's actually not. And it's I wish I could use them. Mm-hmm. My issue is that I'm a Costco.
Oh.
So, yes, it would be if I could tie it to like a Costco pickup.
Okay.
But in here and so we have what we call what does Carla call it? She calls it like the mini Costco. It's downstairs in our basement, and there's a room off the basement that's in the old coal chute and coal cellar for the house. So we put up shelves, and it's actually shelves on both sides and then shelves at the end. So it's pretty much a room of shelves. But everything that we get goes in a specific place. And if there's ever a zombie apocalypse, that's the room you want to raid because that's the equivalent of our entire upstairs is a backup downstairs. So as I go to make the list for Costco, it would be awesome if I had those buttons and just went beep, beep, beep and hit all the things that I need. Mm-hmm. So like if you go down there, like there's jars of peaches and there's jars of applesauce and there's Kleenex and there's paper towels and there's soup. But so I go down the shelves and write down this list. But if I had the Dash button, it would save me a lot of graphite.
That's what I'm saying. I mean, it's the thing that you put, like, because I always have the problem of this is what Siri is. Hey, remind me to do that thing, Siri, because I'm not going to. If I don't put it down, if I don't make this thing happen in some way and get it somewhere out of my head at that moment, it's gone. You know, it's what was I talking about again? You know, and by the time I walk upstairs to pick up my phone to say it, that, you know, but to have the tide button down here by the laundry, it makes absolute sense, right? Because
you're swaying me. I like this.
I mean, you have to, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, because it's a convenience, you know. Like, remind me to pick up milk when I go to the grocery store. How many times you sit at the grocery store and you're like, "What the hell was I supposed to get?" You get home, crap, cat food. That cat's gonna eat me. You know, I mean, mm-hmm. That's exactly the kind of stuff that happens too often, by the way. And I think that's what they're trying to serve there, or the, you know, yelling to that 2001 obelisk named Echo in your kitchen and saying, you know, order me, you know, trash bags or whatever, right? I think that's completely the reason, and there's a need for a need, you know, a first world need, mm-hmm. for that, of course. I think that's perfect. I haven't dived into it, but I really want to. I really want to, but I can't figure out, like, what is that thing that I definitely need all the time that I'll definitely get from Amazon and not worry about that price factor with it. Is you kind of give that up a little bit when you go to Amazon, I've noticed, with those. So, I don't know. It's good to see it. Yeah, the condom one is, you don't hit it when you need it. You hit it where you're like, oh, last one, bink, you know,
proceed. When you're low.
Yeah, when you're low.
Well, that's,
you know,
until they get the drone delivery.
Yeah, the drone delivery.
I mean, you're in the middle of, like, you know, with your lady or whatnot, and you're like, bam, chicken, this little drone just drops off condoms and takes off.
I feel like.
Oh, could you imagine if you're just like Netflix and chill? You're just sitting on the couch watching Netflix, and this drone just shows up with your condoms. You're gonna be like, very awkward all of a sudden. Or you're visiting with like your family, and this drone just drops off condoms. Yes, there's so many awkward situations. This needs to be a sitcom. Drones delivering condoms.
Or that robot that doesn't want to be touched in the junk.
Yes. Yes, exactly.
Don't touch my junk.
All right. Well, my awesome thing of the week. I don't know. Apparently everybody else thinks it's a little more awesome than I originally thought it was. There's this application called Splash. Amanda Narcissi actually passed it my way because, you know, we're looking at a lot of VR and kind of 360 kind of stuff lately. And this application, you can get on your phone, you can look it up, splash.co, and it actually gave me an option to share the video to Facebook. So you can go check it out on my Facebook page, and maybe I'll tweet it out or something. And it has you make, like, you know, you're taking several pictures, it's applying it to a sphere, and you can actually, like, you're not limited. Like, there's the rest of the sphere if I didn't, like, take all the stuff behind me. But the weird thing that happens with this is it's mixing the video, the photography with videos, right? And again, it's an interactive thing that is posted straight to Facebook, just like that pod race scene that we had back in the day when they were first kind of kicking up the Star Wars promotions, right? So this is actually me at Orbis Cafe over in Mount Lebanon. And the stitching's not perfect. You can kind of see, like, why are those buildings so kind of funky? There's two roofs over there on that pizza place, for instance. But then it also does this weird thing where it applies video. So you can, you know, like Snapchat, you can tap to take a picture, like in that square, in that rectangle that is your phone, you know, image, right? Or you can hold down to, like, have a partial video. Now it's just going to show another video. Have another video playing in place. So you could have a video of something that's moving inside this 360 sphere. And it captures the audio through this. Like, I think there's some random audio of the background noise there at the coffee shop in this. I didn't think this was a great thing, but Chilla, you, like, it was like, okay, that's interesting, but I didn't think it served a lot of purpose. Chilla, what did you think when you came across this on my Facebook feed?
So I'm one of the people that just kind of scrolls and scrolls and scrolls until something catches my eye. Then I kind of hone in on that piece, and this definitely stopped. I did not scroll on by your post. It was pretty cool, and it made me go back, okay. And I tapped on it, and it kind of puts it in that circular thing. So I was actually on the train in the morning, so I actually spun around in a circle. People probably thought I was crazy, but it really caught my eye. And some of the stuff that I'm looking at doing with room walkthroughs and tutorials and training stuff for work, I could personally really see this being of value to a lot of people, and the ability. to just post it right up there to me is huge. I've been looking at some stuff with VR, and I know Google's put together some JavaScript that allows people to do VR right in their web page as long as you're on an up-to-date browser. And I just think this makes this gives accessibility to everyone to start posting this type of content.
You know where I'm going with this?
To the elevator?
Why would I go to an elevator?
I don't know.
To a hockey game?
That was your No, where are you going with this?
I have a haunted house.
To buy condoms?
Yes, I'm going to have the drones bring the condoms. And then you can watch everybody's reaction as they're delivered in the room. Oh, I'm so excited. This is going to be the best sitcom ever.
But like I say, it's not, but don't think you're going to have this giant 360 capture of everything going on. You're going to have this piecemeal capture. So, I mean,
you know what? It's awesome.
It kind of...
You're really underselling it.
I guess I am. But it's a nice, accessible way to do that. So I think it's definitely worth looking at. Like I said, splash.co, or look for Splash. It's a green icon there on iPhone. And I don't know if there's a necessarily a Android version as well. But Splash, I'm going to look real quick. Splash.co. I'm sure it's out there. But anyways, so that's our awesome things of the week. Let us know your awesome things. Hit us up on the AwesomeCast Facebook group or on Twitter at AwesomeCast, and we'd love to. That is not the same Splash, apparently.
No, I'm like looking at it going...
Isn't that what it said on the video?
Oh, that's right. That's not it?
No.
Oh, Splash app. Splashapp.co. There we go. I'm glad I went to look.
I was like, that's not...
That's entirely not what they're saying. No, it's only on iPhone right now. Video and 360 using only your iPhone. Again, yeah, we'll see. And they do show in the video on here using some Google Cardboard. So it is going to be compatible for that. I think probably in the app, because you can... Again, it's got its own kind of network in app that'll do that too. So, all right. Hey, you know what's awesome? That's... You know where we need to do a 360 video? Our good friend Slice on Broadway... We got some here for our in-studio guests. Of course, they got their new location down at PNC Park in Carnegie, PA on Main Street, or right here along the tracks, the being worked on currently high construction tracks in Beachview. Please stop by or have them delivered to your place if you're in range. Chilla. And help them out in that regard. For a while now, supporting Pittsburgh... Supporting Pittsburgh podcasting with the perfect pepperoni pizza, now at PNC Park with the home of the Pittsburgh Pirates. Thank you so much to them, Rico and the guys. Great crew down there, great pizza, great ingredients. Like multiple time, I don't know how many Pittsburgh awards they've won for best pizza in town. But really cool place to go. And thanks so much for them for supporting the show. SliceOnBroadway.com, PJH_Slice on the Twitter. And Slice on Broadway on the Facebook and Instagram. Let them know the Awesome Cast sent you. Thanks to them.
I may have missed it. And I actually asked the delivery guy when they delivered my weekly slice. Is PNC Park going to deliver?
I didn't get an answer on that one. I haven't seen yet. There is an appointment at Slice. They need some updates on their page. I know we were just talking about beforehand. I guess it's more of a limited menu that we've heard down there, but that's okay. You know,
that's okay.
Being something in the park like that, I wouldn't imagine they do a full on thing. So, but I love they posted a pregame warm up picture at for opening day down there. So, excited to see them expanding and beyond on that. All right. So I kind of bundled together, since we've been talking a lot of virtual reality, a little bit of a VR corner. OK. We have a couple of stories to touch on there. First of all, I was really interested. Of course, we did just talk about the Splash thing that really kind of fit in this, too. But more 360 than VR, probably. But one that I found and I heard about, and this is the thing that we talked about, like, oh, what are you going to do with VR? Like, oh, it's going to be really great for real estate and home remodeling and everything, right? Well, guess who's getting to that? Of course, IKEA. You can use the HTC Vive, apparently, you can turn your kitchen remodeling into a Vive VR game. And just some imagery right now. You can actually get it for free on Steam right now. And you see these kind of 3D modeling of of your kitchen, and then you can put IKEA furniture wherever you want in it.
Did
and
you
remodel
see
your kitchen.
It's listed under psychological horror?
What?
Geek.com was posting that this app or this game on Steam is listed under psychological horror.
Oh, geez.
Where's it at? Yeah.
Which, okay, there you go. but that's awesome. Go check that out. I mean, you kind of figured like this is kind of like we're seeing the gimmicky and the, I mean, what do you find on the Google Cardboard? Like I found an Audi commercial more or less, right? That you download an app to ride in an Audi and check everything out, right? Or Acura or whatever the heck it was, or Legendary had something that you can like drop into some of their scary movies a little bit, you know. Cedar Point has a roller coaster VR actually. Chilla?
I wonder if places like IKEA using this technology will then be reporting back, like, what's the furniture piece that the person picked the most? What, mm-hmm. Like, if they could start to actually look at configurations that the different people created, will give them new ideas for not only in ad placement, but also in their store configuration. So I could definitely see this being a way to crowdsource a lot of things as well, as long as you have a people that are downloading and using it.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. So go check that out. If you have an HTC Vive, and I got a line on somebody that's going to be our friends over at Actually Looking for Group are getting a Vive here within the next month. So go visit them. And they have all the cool toys, which is really nice over in Brookline. So actually, I think John from over there is going to be on the show within the next 2 weeks, if I was looking at the schedule right. So some cool stuff there. Hey, here's another thing. So, you know, it's really nice. You know, we've been talking about with our, you know, a lot of things with 360 and VR, like Google Cardboard. We have the Google Cardboards. Hell, porn companies are giving away Google Cardboards at this point. So it's really accessible, and it was cool to see this week that Google is going to their new VR view tool is actually going to allow easy embedding of 360 degree content. So they're adding a little more SDK to this thing, and it's even going to give you some more basic scaffolding. It says in this article on Verge for implementing technical features like head tracking and spatial audio. That's stuff that I think for some of us commoners that might be a little hard to. As designers for stuff like this, but this is exactly the kind of we're looking at. You know, I'm looking at what is the option for 360 video because I'm really interested in trying my hand at some of this stuff. Albeit, like I got to get a Ricoh Theta, man, at the very least, and start playing with one of those, right? But you need to do beyond what that camera is that audio work and everything. But again, just a little more to make that easier. And in what is definitely the most accessible way in Google Cardboard. Anybody can do this. Practically anybody interested probably has one of these little guys, an iPhone or an Android device that's going to support this, and they can take their first step into virtual reality and have the ability there, you know, or have nice little giveaways, you know, if you want to do your little sponsor package, if you got some kind of business or something, right? But I think, Chilla, you were talking about this a little bit earlier, right?
Mm-hmm.
So... but good to see some good tools coming out there. Other than that, I know the Oculuses are coming around. I don't think I have it in the rundown, but I know iFixit. There was a part where iFixit was taking it apart, and Palmer Lucky, who we talked about last week, actually delivered the first one to a fellow in Alaska that didn't even have a computer that could run the Oculus Rift games yet. So they just took pictures with it and posed with it, which was interesting. So iFixit took it apart and. Palmer Lucky like dared them to take it apart further to find out what the real magic was inside. To which point they're like, "Well, we're trying to do a non-destructive thing here, Palmer. Can we, do you want us to, you know?" So I thought that was an interesting thing. They're definitely the leader of Oculus is becoming very I guess he's always has been. Very, very personable in this and becoming kind of a figurehead in these kinds of things, which this is his time. This is a guy that like came out of nowhere and figured out VR and now it's arrived. And so he's probably having a real good time right now. So and this is real. And everybody that's getting their hands on the new hardware says it's very, very good, even way better, even than those early SDKs that were out there. So I can't wait to see how that is, because I know the one they have to look for group is fairly bulky, right? So, but
the one thing I would warn people about that view embed is just make sure that the majority of people viewing your site can use that embed. Because I was trying some stuff for work with this, and we're back a couple revisions on Firefox, and we're back on Chrome, and IE's pretty up to date. But just be careful, because not everything can view that embed code.
Yeah, Frank, you were saying something?
I just wanted to check in. I mean, how small do you think these things can go? I mean, they are obviously a bit bulky right now.
The VR headsets?
Yeah.
Pretty low. I mean, I think...
Google Glass with coverage?
I mean, eventually, right?
Yeah,
because right now you need a pretty interesting kind of mirror system situation, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I'd be curious to see how that goes. So, all right. So we'll be right back after this. Of course, a big event happening this weekend, a great comedy event, and we're going to have the commercial here in a moment. Frank, do you have anything you want to say? I know you got a couple of the flyers hanging out over there about this great comedy event happening.
I do. It's this Friday night at Dave & Buster's in Homestead, Pennsylvania, out near the Improv, if you're familiar with that, right next door. It's a good event. Comedians for Cancer. It's for Testicular Awareness Foundation, our friends over at Bar Jitsu Entertainment. They do a lot of beer pong events. They're going to have a little beer pong table set up there in the back room. You can play before and after the show. We're going to have six comics. It's $20. You can get tickets online. Go to show, click, search Matt Light, which is our headliner. Matt Light is a recovering cancer survivor, also a very funny comedian, named Pittsburgh Magazine Comedian of the Year, I think 2014, 2015. So this Friday night, if you check all of our streams, all of our pages, Comedians for Cancer, you can just search that on show, click. So hope to see you Friday night, 9 o'clock show.
All right. Awesome. 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 And check that out. And we'll be right back with more AwesomeCast.
That's awesome.
Hey guys, it's Matt Light, Pittsburgh Magazine's 2014 and 2015 winner, best comedian, and cancer survivor. Come check me out Friday, April 8th for a night of stories, laughter, barjitsu, beer pong, and prizes that will be sure to make this a night to remember. I'll be performing with some of the best comedians in the Steel City. Portions of the proceeds benefit the Testicular Cancer Awareness Foundation. Special thank you to our event partners, FN Vodka, Ultra Premium Vodka, Pittsburgh Improv, Pittsburgh's premier comedy club, Sorgatron Media, podcast, video production, and creative media, Pittsburgh Podcast Network for Pittsburgh by Pittsburgh, River's Edge Radio Network, Pittsburgh's voice for local music. Comedians for Cancer, Friday, April 8th at Dave & Buster's in the Waterfront, the only place to eat, drink, play, watch sports, and laugh all under one roof. Get those tickets, folks. Go to barjitsu.com or showclicks.com and search Comedians for Cancer.
We are back. Hello. It's the Awesome Cast, and we did. If you didn't notice, we might have had some technical issues in those first half. Frank was a little less boisterous than usual.
sounds like you
and,
hear it's like,
and you know that if you've seen him at a party.
Oh yeah, that's right. I didn't have my usual bottle of vodka before the show.
No, yeah, no, we barely had a mic issue, and I think we've corrected it here. So Frank Murgia, of course, Pittsburgh Podcast Network. Thank you so much. Now that we've given you a properly working microphone, it's good to have you.
Bleeding into Katie's
so
microphone.
So we're gonna give you the entire second half of Awesome Cast. Have
oh,
at it.
Awesome cranky Frankie cast. Thank you very much.
Exactly.
But grinds my gears.
Chilla, you brought up an interesting point off air while we were correcting some technical issues.
So yeah, my question was going to be, I think last time Frank was here, he was using an old maybe Android device, or maybe he was back on an older BlackBerry. I can't remember.
Oh.
He was about to get a new device and one of his devices broke.
Mm-hmm.
And he was up in the air on what he was going to get. And so I'm just wondering, what mobile device do you have
I also want to point out, he was very much showing off his old badass BlackBerry at the Christmas party as well. it was a high talking point for much of the night. So
that's right. I was on a BlackBerry Q10, old school. I was all excited about the BlackBerry Priv coming out. Possibly going to get the BlackBerry Priv. But then that thing was gigantic once we actually got to feel it and touch it and see it. So I went to iPhone. I'm back on the iPhone 6S. Nice. I know. I went kicking and screaming. But I love Apple products. I mean, the desktop, iPad, Mac top. But I'm just over the phone anymore.
It's called a Mac top?
Did I call it a Mac top, laptop, iMac, Mac top? Yeah.
Why haven't they capitalized on that? Because that actually kind of works, doesn't it?
The Mac top. Yes,
yeah, the Mac top.
Yeah, so I'm on an iPhone, Chilla, and
I'm hanging in there for now. Still holding hope that a BlackBerry will get its stuff together.
But. I've had my hands on I think it was a Priv, because somebody's like, I don't know if we can get that app on here. It's a BlackBerry. And I looked at it. I'm like, this is Google. What are you talking about? Yeah, I forgot. Like, that's pretty much probably what they're selling for BlackBerry right now, right?
Yeah.
Is that Google version of it? So
they were supposed to come out with some like the same look and feel of the older BlackBerries with the non-slider keyboard, but I haven't seen those. But they run Android. I haven't seen those come out yet. But I've seen a lot of people picking up the Priv for business purposes. To me, it was a little big, and the keyboard keys were a little small. Mm-hmm. But I do, that device is still, well, here, let's put it this way. Verizon decided that they were going to start to carry it because they were getting enough customers going to carriers that were carrying it, since Verizon did not decided they were not going to carry it day one. So it was enough to get them to start offering the device.
Yeah, I think it's got like the BlackBerry Vienna or the Venice. They were talking about maybe April and May, but I think it's – I've not seen much on it in a while. Yeah, it has a nice keyboard on it. It looks like the old – but it runs Google. It runs Android, so that would be great.
Yeah, because that was the thing. I'm like, I got to find the Play Store on this thing. I couldn't find it. They buried it. Like, they did put it up front on this thing. And I'm pretty sure the person that I was helping with the phone was not a person that would rearrange everything on their phone. Like, like factory for the most part. They didn't even have the Play Store set up, so that might have been – you know, the deal. Hey, a note from, and actually I've been watching this on the screensavers, Twit, This Week in Tech, actually on their new screensaver show, which I'm loving, great, great throwback to the good old days there. They built a $5,000 PC to use Oculus Rift.
Ooh.
Not necessary. They admitted you can make a perfectly good, a guy from PC Perspective that helped them said, hey, we made a perfectly good, adequate $900 PC for you to run this thing in, and a pretty good experience. But they went whole hog. It's supposed to be they called it the ultimate gaming machine, which is a thing they used to do back in the day where they spent thousands of dollars on something like that. They had liquid cooling and all this kind of stuff. Yet only one video card, because they're like, oh, it's fine. But everything else was whole hog. So that gives you an idea there. I'll just kind of hang out with my Google. Hey, Chilla, I've been actually wanting to ask you this question off air, but since we're on the line with VR, let's say I just wanted to get a Samsung device to do Samsung gear. Like, what would that put me back at this point? Like, to get like maybe the lowest end one, the cheapest gear that would be compatible with the VR head unit, which is
so you can get the VR head unit for $99, and then they go back as far as the Samsung Galaxy S6.
Mm-hmm.
Hold on 1 second.
We're all checking. No, I'm
You're probably like $350.
$350 plus the $100.
Plus the $100.
So for $450, which again is not. You know, you got to think, like, it's like $600 for the Oculus, but then you have to get the PC to use it. Like, you're basically ready to go at that point. No, it's not going to be as great of an experience, but it's you got the experience, right? So,
mm-hmm. So, and I'm guessing if you gave it another couple months, I'm guessing you're going to see an S, like, you're going to see the next iteration of Note, mm-hmm. and you're going to see a Galaxy S7 Plus and Edge Plus. So I'm guessing that'll push the S6 price down probably another $100. So I'm guessing by summertime, you're going to see that price drop from like a $350 to a $250, especially as the iPhone 5 SE is hitting that $399 point, that those prices are just going to go down, down, down.
Right. And they are. I just looked real quick. For even get on Gazelle, you can get a certified pre-owned Galaxy S6 Verizon for like $350. And again, I'm thinking like, you know, get one that it's not for a phone. It's just a thing to put in there. And it's a shame that the Samsung doesn't have a non-cell like iPod Touch version. I know they used to. Like back in the day, I think everybody tried something
and
like that.
Someone was saying that there were rumors of that potentially coming back around, because they did a short run of an iPod Touch / Microsoft Zune type device to try to compete in that market. And they just, Android was a little too new. We're talking back in the gingerbread days. But I think they could definitely make a run at that market again.
All right. I wanted to talk about, because I think this is the big news right here this week. And I mean, well, we all own cars, so I think we all have an opinion of some sort. Tesla unveils the Model 3, which is the affordable model. Should I put quotation marks in there? Yeah, I mean, we're starting at $36,000, but you're not getting away with it. It's like, you know, you're going to get that iPhone, but you're going to have to buy all the dongles, right? You're not getting out at that low price point. You know, yeah, you're going to get an Apple Watch for $300, but let's be honest. You're not getting the one you want for $300. So this has been the big news the last couple of days, and it's a beautiful freaking car for one thing. I'm always weirded out about the dashboard inside that just has like a giant glass panel in the middle that has all the readouts on it, which is now landscape, by the way. That's the big news too. And while we're at it, they actually it's slated for 2017. Some people sitting on the last Tesla pre-orders still haven't received theirs, by the way. So you could get it whenever they're ready. But you had to put $1,000 on it for that. And you could get it anywhere from like 2017 to actually, I think, honestly, 2019 for that. And they got twice the Model 3 pre-orders it expected. Was it like 276,000 pre-orders?
They even did pre-orders in Ross Park Mall. Did they? I don't know. Oh my God. So there was like a line.
Wow.
Wrapped around a section of the mall. I saw it on the news. I was amazed. But yeah, you could go to Ross Park Mall last week and you could pre-order. And there was actually a person in line wearing Google Glass.
No. Oh, no. My gosh. Oh, jeez.
He's on Splash making a 360 video.
Yeah, he is. Oh, jeez. He's wow.
I'm surprised that he underestimated. I mean, it's a lot, but mm-hmm. he was way under what he thought.
Right.
It's a great price. Why not? We know why not.
Having $36,000, I mean, I haven't had a new car ever in my lifetime. But
he's Kickstartering. It's just a big Kickstarter project.
It really is. And it proves that people want this, right?
Yeah.
You know, in a world where Chevy's making an equivalent car now, mm-hmm. I don't want much about it. I've just been heard kind of tangentially in these stories, but that shows Tesla is like not going to go away anytime soon at this point. And this is for real. Whether they can deliver in quantity is the question, it seems. But there's been a couple of these out on the road. I've heard on other podcasts, you know, Twit and Tech News Show and everything, saying like, this is basically, you know, everybody that bought the, what was it, $150,000 version when they first came out with is basically bankrolling getting to this point that everybody can get one and building that business. And it's pretty ingenious there. And it's pretty cool to see the electric car happening and in private hands. So, you know, it won't get killed off like in the 90s. So you mentioned Ross Park Mall. I've seen them around. Like, I see them around town in Pittsburgh, you know.
I see them. There's someone that drives one to the Target at South Hills Village all the time.
Of course. I mean, you know, you're not seeing the, I don't see much in Beachview, you know, especially
an Uber driver in one of those things. We just get a ride around
You know, you'd probably do good business with that. You're like, does it say make and model the car an Uber, right? Yeah. So yeah, I'd be looking for like Tesla. Like, can you pick your driver? Or like when it comes up, or does it say, hey, this guy's ready to come get you? I did it once and I can't remember.
I think it's closest to you.
It's the closest to you, whatever it was. It just kind of gives you that model so you can look for it. You just like cancel on this way. You're like, nope. Let's see if I can get Tesla on this next one. I think it's really cool to see that kind of building up and what they're doing. And I still kind of wrap my head around, like, because I think there is a lot of like car automation features they're putting in. I love that they talk about this as if like, oh, it's a feature you got to put in. Like it can come with new front wheel drive, but then you can have it added to have four wheel drive. But they literally have to put another motor in for the other axle, basically, because that's just kind of how it functions. So pretty interesting to see that. Katie, your Miss Splash 360 video picture that looks very lewd is distracting me over here, by the way. I don't think I can show that on the screen.
Well, you should see it when it's a video form. It's even better. That's what we were giggling about.
I'm haunted. I'm disturbed. Yeah,
that looks like it's somebody's arm is sticking out of the
the
And that's one of those awkward things when I was looking at the splash. Like,
that's what I said.
Yeah, that guy's going to need to hit the dash button for that Trojan condom pretty soon. Things are about to bust loose all over the place.
Awesome. Frank.
Yeah, I know.
No, I'm not scolding you. I'm asking you to talk about something.
Now that my microphone finally works.
Let's have you go old school.
And it just turns off all of a sudden.
tell me about, Frank, you just put your name a bunch of times here. I'm trying to figure out what's happening.
Tell me about
your razor.
You know, I said it was cranky, a little cranky Frankie. Cranky and awesome, cross them. The razor. I think the basic big
razor.
Wait.
Is this the razor, the phone?
That would be great. The phone razor.
You might have one of those. Just like
I used to have a razor phone.
A pink razor phone in your back pocket right now.
I missed the clamshell.
Those razors
phone.
Were near indestructible, by the way.
They really were. I'm talking about a basic big razor. And now, of course, I have a beard. I haven't shaved. But I picked up a razor for a little bit of touch-up. You know, I don't need to keep it clean. And I just bought a basic couple disposable pick shavers.
It's one of these?
That is it. Old school, yellow stick.
Yeah.
Like a number two pencil.
Yeah.
And I use it. And I go, this works just fine. This works fine. We have a two blade. There's a three blade. Then there's the XL. Then there's the four blade. You need five titanium blades. Then there's Dollar Shave Club. Again, how lazy are we that we need the shavers delivered to our front door? You know, but a basic shaver works for me. I'm over the shaver. I'm over the expensive $10, $12 blade. So, folks, I'm just here to tell you, get a nice Bic razor. It works. It's fine. Just don't use it for 3 months because then it's like, using a machete.
That's been my problem because I keep forgetting to pick up the razors. I need the dash button right there in the bathroom when I'm like, wow, this really hurts.
See how it circles back?
You know, this really hurts. I need to hit
that
button.
When was my last tetanus shot?
Exactly. You know, I mean, I'm just chopping this mug up every morning, you know, so.
That beautiful mug.
It's like patches of grass that I'm missing in here, but
an old blade from Sawtooth Willie.
Yeah, exactly. New episode up today with Savannah Nevada, by the way.
She's awesome. I don't know who's cooler, Penny or Savannah.
Penny Avocado and Savannah Nevada.
Yeah, I don't know which one's cooler.
Sawtooth Willie. Really good feedback on Savannah Nevada. The most hits ever gotten on our Facebook video. So
it's the name people
it's the name. Well, I next week you'll find out what the name means. Yes, and
I can't wait to find out
the deep dark secret, the deep dark secret of Savannah, Nevada, and Sawtooth Willie. Yeah.
Will you be crossing over to Arrow and Flash and some other episodes, Supergirl?
The only thing better than watching those episodes is watching me watch them because I don't like to watch myself to begin with, and then I watch my and it's just literally me just like.
Well, I know, and Will like goes back. He genuinely does not remember. He says on these things, right?
Well, I think Will and I just go out of our bodies. We were actually these characters, and we are gone. Like we watch them like the rest of you. We have no idea what's going to happen.
And of course, we did film this back in December.
Yeah, that's another
reason. I mean, so there's a lot of time in there for you to say, what did we do there? And I'm like, hey guys, new episode. It'll be new to you too. And plus, you know, when we hit the editing floor, what do we do with it? Like, you know, you never know what that cutoff point is going to be. And that seems to be one of the high points for these things lately. So
look at that image.
Yeah, look at that. There you go. She's rocking the Starbucks cup with her name on it. You know, as you do, of course.
My devil box.
Your devil box.
And it's not what you think.
Nope. There is a technology definitely spin to this as well. So go check it out. Sawtooth Willie on YouTube and the Facebook. I turned into an ad, I know. But all right. Chilla. Kitty, do you have any stories? Am I missing in here?
Oh,
there
April
is one.
Fools.
No, we'll hold on to that. We'll hold on to that.
That's gold.
We put the angry things at the end. Chilla, what happened at the Build College conference? I guess I did put half of these in here,
it was funny because I was like, "This is awesome! I don't have to type anything or copy everything.
Nope, good to go.
Sorg just does it all.
Yep.
So what happened at Build? Cortana happened. They want her on every device, everywhere.
Listen,
for everything.
I have a feud with Cortana because I had to take the Windows laptop because the Mac was busy rendering stuff, so I had to get some stuff done. And I'm sitting at a coffee shop, and Cortana keeps popping up, telling me she didn't get that. I wasn't talking. I don't know what she's picking up on.
She should have probably muted the mic or something.
I don't know how, because Windows 10. But yeah.
That's why, just because Windows 10.
Exactly.
So they definitely want her to be cross-platform. And I've heard Krauss should be the one spreading the Microsoft propaganda, or maybe not, because he's, I think, moving away from Microsoft now.
We got to get him on to get that conversation.
Yeah, we got to get him on to get that conversation started. But a lot about Cortana, I hear a lot of more partnerships with or spreading additional favoritism towards Android with some cross-platform notifications. If you're familiar how that works with Android and Galaxy Gear type watches or the Pebble, they're bringing a lot of that capability to Windows and across to Android as well. And it seems like Cortana is kind of bridging that gap from that perspective. I think you have some information here. They're trying to make friendly with the Linux world.
Yeah, bash commands.
So they're coming out with command line tools, which I thought was awesome. Like, you can get
Can you explain that to me? Can you explain that to the rest of us? Why is that awesome?
Because if that's what you're familiar with.
Okay, but we're talking about developers. We're talking about, like, what level of people are we talking about here?
So the bash command line and shell that's on every flavor of Linux. So if let's take it like this. So if you're a Linux person and you created a bash script, and it did things like displaying a directory's contents, right? You don't type dir in that command line. You type ls. So all that command line to come over for those developers to create those command line tools is coming over to Windows as part of the Windows 10 anniversary update. So that's where I think you're going to see a lot of people. Remember the old batch files and Windows script?
Mm-hmm.
You're going to see a lot of those little tips, tricks, and nuggets and tools to automate things.
So a lot of customization. Jeez, yes, that word.
Customization. So I think you'll see some customization, but I think what you're more going to see is, hey, I need something that's going to automate my photo workflow, and it's going to grab location data and make it part of the file name. So you dump all your pictures down from your iPhone or Android device, right? And they just come in as whatever the beginning is, and then a number .jpg or whatever that format is. Now, if you wrote a bash script that took that and made it image the number and then the location it was taken in, and maybe some other pieces of that image data, you could automatically pull that out with something like a bash script.
Yeah.
So that's where I could see a lot of these little tools that those developers want. They're going to now not have to relearn a different scripting language, and that's where I think Microsoft's really going.
Yeah.
So they're trying to appeal to both people that aren't on the Microsoft platform as well as on the platform. They made some announcements about or went back over their Xamarin purchase. So they have tools that will allow you to take .NET and create any of your .NET applications for Android and iOS. Mm-hmm. I think it's all about bringing the outside developers in and also exposing their developers' toolkits to allow them to develop cross-platform. So
it's awesome.
And it sounds like,
as Krauss is saying, you know, admins and Linux developers, like in general, like, it's going to be great for it. And this is just a big breaking down of platforms between that and the iOS and Android stuff, certainly. So it's awesome to see.
They had some cool HoloLens stuff, Cortana on the HoloLens. I saw where they were also walking on Mars with Buzz Aldrin.
Don't mind the snickering. They're doing selfies on the couch over there. So while we're talking about Microsoft and developers, so
they showed something else for HoloLens. They showed a bunch of TVs up on a wall. They shipped the developer first day of build, they also shipped all the developer equipment out. So any of the original developers get it looking for that equipment or getting the first shipments. Like I said, the notifications go cross-platform.
Mm-hmm.
The interesting thing that I thought I put a link in here. Will it catch? So the other interesting thing that happened in amongst build was Gartner released some of their new metrics for where iOS, Android, and Windows fall.
Mm-hmm.
And I was surprised because they're estimating this year will be the first year iOS and OS X outpace Windows platforms. So it'll be interesting to see if that does come to fruition, as well as Microsoft kind of stated they were taking some time off from the phone platform. The phones are still going to be out there. But I was expecting
We're going to take a powder on phone platforms for a while. Sorry, people that bought our phones.
That kind of caught me off guard, especially because I keep seeing more stuff in the media about Continuum, which is the whole concept of taking a phone, putting it in a dock, and then allowing that to be used as a kind of a full-fledged Windows machine. I think the universal binaries are something that's going to help that really catch. And I think they announced also at build that Facebook, Instagram, and someone else had all gone the universal binary route. So the same application that runs on Windows will run on the phone, that'll run on potentially Xbox, et cetera.
This ends up, basically it doesn't matter that you have Windows. It matters that you're using Office in the platforms at this point, and they're breaking that down. So, I mean, and again, this is, I don't know, that sounds terribly exciting at this point. Is this something that you're going to see kind of develop over years as people start applying these tools? Since this is a developer conference, of course, kind of like how WWDC, hey, that's a developer conference. It's not necessarily for you guys when they have those announcements, other than they do start talking about the iOS that's coming up and everything. So, but no, I think it's really good to see kind of where they're going, and it'll be curious to see if this new strategy, like I think a lot of other strategies have been with this new Satya Mania openness that they've been doing. So
I'd like to see, the one thing I would like to see is more commercials
for Microsoft.
Yeah, because do you remember the Lumia that was at the 1020 with the parents in the back of the auditorium?
Yeah, I do. I feel like they need more of the IBM style commercials where there's like, hey, we're kind of everywhere, and that's all you really mm-hmm. need to know, or something that says, oh yeah, I'm using Office and I'm on an iPad, or I'm on this and I'm on this. Oh, it's everywhere. Like that kind of awareness, I think, needs to happen. So the people that see nothing but MacBooks in their coffee shops don't think Microsoft has dead. And that continues to perpetrate that. So, are you periscoping? We've got periscopes happening. We got video feeds all over the place happening on this show. Technology. developers. Hey, Frank, okay. I think you have our tip of the week by chance here. So, what's going on here?
Keeping it old school like I do with mm-hmm. my Bic razor and Bic shaver.
Keeping us grounded.
That's right. Mm-hmm. Keeping us grounded. I brought papers. Everybody has like unit. Chilla, you'll love this. It's a BlackBerry, papers, notes.
Wait, on this blue paper, like is that leftover from?
I do all blue. Everything's all blue paper. All blue paper. Like a blue, nice blue. Tip of the week, how to know if your batteries are dead. There's the old simple way. Of course, we have a video I think we can show that you mm-hmm. can put it up on. The 9-volt battery is easy. Put it up in your tongue, a little zip. Ooh, still got some life to it. You're fine. But the other batteries, the A, AA, AAA, you really can't put those on your tongue. You really can't tell. Of course, you can buy a little fancy, charger and stick that on the end of the plus and the minus. But who carries those around? Unless you have a dash button, you could probably order one. In 2 days, you have one. Yeah. But if you take a battery, you can just bounce it off the ground, and it should not bounce. You just drop it on a table. A fresh battery should not bounce.
Really?
It's going to tell us right here.
Yeah.
I believe it's the... the zinc in there, when it's all compact, when it's fresh, you drop it, it won't bounce. But once it starts utilizing it and it loosens up in there, it'll bounce. Let's see.
What about rechargeables?
That's a good question. What's in a rechargeable? We're watching a little video now. We're going to find out.
Hold on.
Watching things go boom.
Inside the battery, zinc metal changes to zinc oxide.
This does not bounce, by the way. Bounce. It does not bounce.
Is that a new one?
Yeah, I don't know. They're just rechargeables.
Yeah, the battery's new. The zinc and metal's tightly packed, so it doesn't bounce. So you don't have to put your tongue on it. You don't have to buy a dash button, a battery charger checker. So,
and this is a video from TechInsider.io. Yeah. Battery dead test 2016.
Very cool.
Wow, that's pretty cool. So
simple and easy. It will not bounce.
Just hear all this clanging downstairs. What? Honey, what are you doing down there? I'm testing batteries. You know.
Why waste money on this battery tester?
Is this good? I don't know. You know. Throw it down.
I will say, when you and Chilla were talking, I don't know what I felt violated, like that robot we talked about earlier. Katie was doing things with Snapchat that I have never seen. She's got filters. I mean, I don't know. Hopefully, we can delete all those. I didn't even
record any of those.
Oh, good. Oh, gosh.
It was just fun.
She was doing great things. Her Snapchat game.
Like, were you doing face swaps and stuff?
Yeah. We did face swaps.
Yeah, no. Those tend to get creepy.
Very creepy. And I'm glad they weren't live. Her Snapchat
or just
game
like,
is
hold them up, like hold up like pictures of like famous people, you know, like mm-hmm. like we could do. Didn't you or somebody do one with Roman Reigns over here?
Yeah, I saw faces with the Piper. Gosh. Everybody
yeah.
who had a face.
Oh yeah, on the cup, you know, like yeah, it's people have been using that in interesting ways. I've noticed. So there was one more. I went. Oh, Katie.
This is Sorg's favorite day of the year.
Yay!
April Fool's Day! Okay, this was our favorite. Well, my favorite.
It's the favorite.
Yeah, it's the best thing ever. Some of you may have saw how Google kind of really, Gmail really screwed up theirs with the mic drop, and it was the same shortcut as the archive button. So
it also screwed things up, and like there was it turned off replies apparently for some people too. Just completely botched that thing. So.
Yeah, so there were some errors, some coding there. But the one we loved the most was Corn Hub, which was Pornhub, who was now just sponsoring all sorts of corn loving. Why is Corn Hub premium butter? No commitments. And there's a sexy video at the bottom of Mr.
Oh,
and Mrs.
No.
Corn,
oh, whoa, look at it go.
Mr. and Mrs. And Mrs.
Those corns
yeah,
are.
There's just stuff happening everywhere. I'm here, you know.
Oh, they're getting corny. Oh,
she
my
goes
gosh.
Crazy for his salty taste. Watch full scene. Slum on the cob. Where's the first time kernel popping?
So this has been the bane of my existence this week because I don't get caught on April Fool's Day. Well, no, I did. Because I had a busy, busy Friday, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I finally sat down like 3 in the afternoon and started going through my email and I'm starting going through that promo tab in Google Inbox. And I'm going, and I have my automatic thing for the car, right? And there's this email is like, automatic is now going to be manual. And it looked like a thing. It was like, oh, we're changing our company name. Like, Google changed the alphabet or something, right? And I'm like halfway through the article. And I'm like sometimes like, wait, something isn't right. They're talking about notebooks for some reason. And then I pop down and it's April Fool's. Now, the problem is, I like to look at Facebook before I go to bed, right? And even today I saw, or no, this was last night, right before going to bed, just flipping through Facebook and saw something about Marvel just announced Bullseye and She-Hulk and Elektra's coming to Netflix. I'm like, that sounds like something that could happen, right? That doesn't sound outside. And I shared it. The last line, April Fool's. And it says 3 days ago, not April 1st, right? And just didn't do the math on it. And I did. That might be the second or third time I did it. Sometimes I do it on purpose. Sometimes I do it to see if anybody else does it. Like the Bruce Campbell Doctor Who one coming to Sci-Fi, and everybody just like, please, please, yes, yeah, no. But that's where I'm at with it. I'm kind of over it. Nothing has been clever enough to get over being annoying.
That's because we had questioned at Scarehouse. We had questioned whether to do something for April Fool's Day. And then it's either you have to be so funny that it's ridiculous right away because you don't want to risk that someone getting through something and being angry because they're like, oh, man, this sounded like something that could really happen. Or then you don't want to be so cheesy that it's like, really, come on. Be that guy.
Yeah, I was going to bring up Jack's Bar on the South Side. You heard about that, obviously, for April Fool's. Our buddy John Chamberlain from Yajagoff and the Jagoff blog. He stopped by there. So on April Fool's Day, there was a couple days prior, they sent out a press release to all the press, media, the news, KDK, everybody, that Jack's was taking over new ownership and they'll be changing their name to Jim's. So they had a big press conference down at Jack's. They had to sign out front. It was said Jim's, and they had a ribbon cutting. And then they revealed to everybody it was just a, you know, April Fool's joke. They're really not changing to Jim's. There wasn't a takeover. But every year they will celebrate and change the name. Well, apparently, like people like in KDK or the Post Gazette got really mad because they sent reporters down there. They sent camera crews, reporters.
they spent money on it.
Yeah. Right? Yeah. Yeah. They spent money on the prank. And then also the networks and media spent money to send people out there to cover it. And it was an April Fool's prank.
Apparently, there were memos going around. I don't know if it was CBS or some of the, I don't know, local affiliates or like some of the news. Like there was a memo. It's April Fool's. Be very careful about what you're running with today and everything.
We actually got some like notes at work. Like, be careful what gets reported as far as issues today. make sure you're accurately identifying issues so they're not taken as a prank. Like, I was surprised at how many people were like on like the fear watch for April Fool's gone wrong.
I think George Takei was the one that posted something that this is the only day of the year we actually really examine things we find on the internet.
It's the only day of the year where people don't believe everything they read on the internet.
Yeah,
I think it was
something along those lines. Yeah.
from the chat, who shared this? Kraus actually shared the self-driving bicycle. Is this a Google? Yeah, from Google Nederland.
Nederland.
Google. Other than that one flop, Google tends to have the best ones and has the most production into them that they're at least entertaining.
Yeah.
Snoopavision.
Oh my.
Did you guys check out Snoopavision? I noticed that I was doing a legit thing on YouTube. I was doing a live stream for a community urban development forum. And then I go and it's like, and we're done with it. And I'm looking to record back to it. And I'm like, what is this icon in the corner? It's Snoopavision. and there's a video and they got Snoop Dogg. He's in a bow tie and he's developing this thing. And what it is, it's a 360 video that puts a video and they've made like a bunch of their own videos with Snoop Dogg, like Snoop Dogg hanging with Larry King. And I didn't look. I think it would play any video that you would select. But you're in a theater watching the video on the screen. And around you, if you look around in the 360 video or on cardboard, is a bunch of Snoop Dogs doing different things, like eating Twizzlers over here, eating popcorn over here, on a cell phone over here, you know, like that kind of stuff, you know, all right around behind you. Like, that was fun. Mm-hmm. And using a real new technology, right? So I thought that was really cool. So Snoopavision wins the April Fools. articles, screw you, because that perpetrates throughout the internet. It doesn't stop. You can't turn them off on April Fool's Day.
That's right. Days later, you're still sending them out.
they're still popping up in my news feed on Tuesday after the Friday April Fool's, and I think it's kind of an issue. So
I think Wendy Bell tried to maybe say her thing was an April Fool's joke, but it didn't work. If you want to go there on AwesomeCast, but we won't.
Nope. No.
Nope, that's a different show.
Yeah, we'll have a social media do's and don't show.
Yes, we will.
Sooner or later.
Uh-huh.
And we'll
edit, delete.
Kind of work on that.
Control.
Hey, Pittsburgh's strong. But anyways, thank you, AwesomeCast. Thank Frank Murgia for joining us.
Thank you.
Pittsburgh Podcast Network. A lot of great things going on over there, right?
Oh, yeah. Maybe some big announcements coming up soon. Stay tuned.
Ooh. All the plugs.
We all had to scare house. Ooh. Ooh. Ghost whistle.
Yeah. but of course, you jag us over there and a bunch of other great shows.
Hopefully, you see at the comedy show, Sorgatron Media, River's Edge.
That's right.
That. Yeah.
We'll be coming. Katie is at Katie Dutters, and she is often hanging out at the Scare House.
Yes. Scare House and everywhere else I can just randomly appear, I feel like, anymore. Here I am.
Wherever that takes, whether have zombies, will travel.
Yes.
And by the way, if you want to rent a zombie, that is a service. Mm-hmm. That is a real service that you're doing now, right?
Mm-hmm.
So
rent a friend.
Rent a friend.
I can't get a real life friend. Here's your half dead.
Exactly. And then a bunch of other interesting off season things. Ask Katie about those on the Twitter.
Twitters.
Chilla at Chilla. Oh. There was a thing in here that we didn't get to.
There was a thing in there that you didn't get to. We can do it next week if you want.
Wait. Your new thing? Can we talk about your new thing?
But the new thing, it was kind of built onto another thing.
Yeah, save it for next week.
Okay, well, Chilla has a thing.
It'll be a...
Dutters is like, I'm not coming in next week, so I don't have to deal with it.
Next week will be you presenting your thing to the world.
Wow. You thought I was bad.
Ooh, I just saw a thing in here.
Yeah.
Wow.
I was looking at his thing.
This is
That's why I thought it needed more time.
This is a pretty cool thing.
Dang.
Yeah, it's a big thing. Chilla has a big thing.
At Chilla is going to talk about the thing on the Twitter, so please go say hi to him or ask him, what is the thing?
Hey, come feel free to ask me what the thing is. I might tell you.
It might tell you, or we'll unveil it next week there at Chilla on the Twitter. Thank you, everybody. AwesomeCast.net, live.sorgatronmedia.com around 6:30 p.m. Eastern Time every Tuesday. Don't worry if you're late, because we probably will be too. Subscribe to the show. Please leave comments. As long as the show's gone, as long as I know people are listening, nobody's ever left a comment on our awesome cast on iTunes that I don't think ever. So I would like that to change. This is the week.
Something has to be wrong then.
What's that?
Something has to be wrong.
Do we think
then.
iTunes we to, is?
I'll help you revalidate this, but I swear, I've left comments.
What?
Yes.
I'll have to look at that. I'm going to pull it up right now. Hold on.
So either I'm not doing it properly.
I had Force Awakens queued up in my iTunes apparently. I watched today. There's an awesome thing of the week. Also awesome Disney Anywhere. Yeah. Thankfully, Disney is everything I want to watch between the Marvel and Star Wars right now. So keep buying stuff, Disney. It's working out real well. A little better than Ultraviolet, even. Go check out everything. Thank you so much to our Patreon supporters, patreon.com/awesomecast. And you can hit us up at AwesomeCast on the Twitter or on the Facebook page. And if you missed this show, which would be weird because we're on demand typically, you can go over riversedgepgh.com Thursday morning, 8 a.m. after Funny Money, and check out all the great stuff and shows going on over there as well. And check out all the podcast stuff. Our friends, of course, the Epicast Network have a lot of great shows. And PodCamp Pittsburgh has a lot of events coming up, from boot camps with introductions to podcasting to a great podcaster panel. We already announced on, I believe it's May 12th off the top of my head, we already announced Professor Buzzkill will be joining that panel. And we have some pretty interesting people we're yet to name for that. Hopefully you'll hear about that in the coming week here. So it'll be a lot of fun up there at Work Hard Pittsburgh. So thanks, everybody. Frank Murgia, at Kate Dutters, at Chilla. Thank you to our awesome chat room rocking all night long. You've been our awesome audience. Have an awesome week. This show is a member of the Sorgatron Media Podcast Network. Find out more at sorgatronmedia.com.